Now we start doing operations on vectors. Okay, what we do, see how addition is defined first of all. Okay, and there is a very commonsensical way of understanding it, that suppose someone goes from here to here, okay, followed by that he goes from here to here. So first he goes from A to B, then he goes from B to C. Then what happens? What is the resultant? What is the impact of all this movement? That means which is one vector which will result in the same displacement. So the vector that results in the same displacement is the vector. So this is C, okay, AB, BC. Then a vector which has the same impact as AB and BC combined together is AC, isn't it? That's why we say that for vectors AB plus BC is actually equal to AC. Now let us do not get confused as because this is not an addition of the magnitudes. It is vectors being added. Okay, if this is, let's say, 3 and this is 4, then the sum of these two will obviously be greater than the third. That is a triangle inequality law. So don't get confused. We are just not talking about the magnitudes. We are talking about a vector addition. Okay, till now we have been adding the magnitude, so we feel that if this is 3, this is 4, then this has to be 7. No, it has to be less than 7. Otherwise this will not be a triangle. Even if it becomes equal, it will not be a triangle. Okay, so this is a time whereby you will have to drop that notion of numbers being added, of masses being added, of maybe temperatures being added or whatever. Okay, the addition vector is the third vector, which is kind of the third side of a triangle, and that's why this is called triangle law of addition. Triangle law of addition of vectors. Okay, this is called the triangle law of addition of vectors, because the third thing actually forms a triangle. Okay, now what do we do if we have more than two vectors? Okay, so addition of more than two vectors, what do you do? So let us take the same case. Okay, instead of this, after we had gone there, maybe say there is this vector, okay, and then let's say there is this vector, and then he went there, okay, and then he came like that. Then what happens? At a time you take two vectors, okay, at a time you take any two vectors and apply the triangle law of addition, and what does it say? So the green one will be the addition of first two vectors, Now to this resultant I add this. So what happens? It becomes this. Okay? And to this addition, okay? So you see, if this is my first vector, this was followed by the second vector. So green and the blue, they gave me the red. You saw that? First of all, this vector A and the vector B, that gave me the green vector. This is, let's say, C, let's say D. That gave me the green vector R1. Now, R1 and C, they add by the same law. What happens? There are two vectors. They are positioned head to tail. And what is the resultant vector? From the tail of the first to the head of the second. That's what. So it satisfies those conditions. Yes, at the head of this, there is the tail of this vector. And from the tail of the first, we connect the head of the second by a straight line. That is your resultant. Okay. So your second resultant becomes maybe between these two. This is R2. The red one is R2. Then R2 plus this. Okay. So this will give you maybe another vector R3, or let it be the final. Now this exercise gives a very, very simple way of adding even 100 vectors. What does it say? Ultimately, what has happened? Ultimately, what is my resultant R? And what is R? R is, you see, the first vector, at the head of this, the tail of the other vector, at the head of that, the tail of the other vector, at the head of that, tail of the other vector. And what happens? The final resultant is from the tail of the first vector to the head of the last vector. Last vector. Okay? You'll have to. Geometrically you can find like this. Arithmetically we'll see what to do. We'll
definitely see. To find R1 and R2.
That's what I said. It's not necessary. So what are we saying? If there are multiple vectors, then arrange them, say arranged in head to tail fashion, then the resultant vector, that is the sum of the vectors, okay? Vector, that is sum of the vectors, sum of these vectors is the vector with its tail at the tail of the first vector and its head at the head of the last vector. Is that clear? What if the vectors are not arranged head to tail fashion? Then we know we have been dealing with, see, if vectors not arranged head to tail, in head to tail fashion, then what you do? You do that. Fine? Then arrange them by moving parallel to themselves. You understand? we have said we are dealing with free vectors. So if I move a vector parallel to itself, what happens? The vector remains the same. It does not change. Okay, that's why we are able to do it, by moving parallel to themselves, so that they are arranged head to tail. So see, if I have maybe this B as this and say C as this, then what do? I'll shift this vector parallel to itself. Okay, so my B vector comes here. Okay, and sorry. This should come to the head of this. Okay, and this should come to the head of this. Okay, so it becomes B. This becomes C. And there is another interesting thing. The order is absolutely immaterial. The order is absolutely immaterial. That means it is associative. Whatever you do, whichever you take parallel, it is not necessary that to A you bring B. You take this there. It will give you the same vector. So here the resultant is this. You understand? Here the resultant is this, not this. Is this? This is the result. Get it? Had I moved A parallel to this, let's do that. Had I moved A parallel to this, so A would have become like that. Okay? Something like that. A bit shorter maybe. Yes. And C would have come here, right? So C would have come here. And you'll get vector, this green vector. Now you see, though this has been done so roughly, still these two vectors have the same magnitude and are parallel to themselves. So what does it mean? They are actually the same vectors. They are equal vectors. By the definition of equality of vectors, they are equal. So what is there? This resultant R1 and this resultant R2 is the same, you see? So it simply does not matter. You have got 100 vectors, you pick up any of them, move any other 99 parallel to itself, okay? Then out of the 98, you have your choice, you pick any and bring it parallel to itself. Just keep on doing that. After you finish with all the 100 vectors, you connect the tail of the first to the head of the last. That is the resultant. You understand? Head to tail arrangement, and then after you have finished, tail of the first to the head of the last. That's all. Okay? That is all. Fine?